Tip number 41, add more information on seal screen of some components. For example, connectors, slots, and this kind of components. And instead of trying to explain you this tip, I'm going to show you some examples so you can see it by yourself how it can be useful and how important it can be. Here is the first example. It's going to be a hard one. I'm going to ask you a question. Do you know what is this? This is a footprint of an SD card slot. Yeah. Here you can see these are the pins of SD card interface. Here are the pins which are connected to ground and card detect signal. Now, the question is, what do you think from what direction the SD card is going to be inserted into this slot? So when you are plugging in the SD card, are you going to plug it in from this direction, from the bottom, or from this side, or are you going to plug in the SD card from the top, or from this side? What do you think? Couple of more seconds. Time is out. Here is the answer. Can you see the answer? The SD card can be inserted into this slot from this direction, from the top. This is the kind of information which you may want to, which you don't have to, but you may want to include on the seal screen. Everyone who was guessing that the direction is from the top, well done. Everyone who was guessing from the bottom, don't worry. In many, many cases, the SD card is usually inserted from the opposite side where the pins are located. But that's why I selected this as an example, because it can help you to understand, you know, how important it can be to add this kind of small information. I know this because I almost made mistake once with a very similar SD card slot. I almost placed it the other way around. Since then, I'm adding this kind of information. What else could be useful? What kind of additional information? Have a look on the connectors. It's weird now. What is this? Do you know? Here you can see two additional information for connectors. One information is speaking about from what direction the cable is going to be connected. So this is HDMI connector and the cable can be plugged in from this direction. This and this, it is telling us how wide the HDMI cable can be. Yeah, when we were drawing a footprint for this HDMI connector, we found all the kind of different HDMI cables which we had in office. We measured how wide they are and we used the widest dimension in the footprint and we draw it like this. Similar for a USB connector. This is USB connector. Here you can see information about the direction and about how wide, in this case, for example, memory stick can be here. You may be very, very surprised how wide some of the memory sticks can be. Now, what do you think? This is the crucial moment here. What do you think why we place this kind of information on the connectors? How it can be useful? Without this information, it can be, you know, very tempting to place the connectors closer to each other. Let's say like this, for example, yeah? You may want to try to make your board smaller, so you just place the connectors closer. See? What is the problem? Here is the problem. My wife, she would say problem is everywhere, but in our situation, the problem is only here at this moment. So here you can very nicely see that if we place the connectors like this, you may not be able to plug in the HDMI connector and the USB memory stick at the same time, because they would be in conflict. So this is the right distance between the connectors. So you can fit all the kind of HDMI cables and also the USB memory stick and the other USB devices. That's why we use this information. I'm pretty sure you understand. Here is different example. This, okay, this is the last one. Normally, this is how the connector look. Where I have it, it's here. It's a kind of simple connector, not the simplest one, but normally if you were creating footprint for this kind of connector, what you may want to do, you just may want to place there four pins and draw outline around the connector. But if you have a careful look on the connector, you can see it's special, yeah? There is the back end, which goes from the edge to the edge of the connector, and there is this front end of the connector, which is a little bit shorter. It's there to prevent the cable plugging in the wrong direction. Yeah? So you can only plug in the cable in the right direction. Okay, what's wrong with this? Why we are speaking about seal screen for this kind of connector? Because if you do not add this information, if you do not draw this line here and this one here, what can very easily happen during the assembling process, the people that are fitting this connector, they can very easily plug in this connector the other way around. That's why we add this kind of information on the seal screen, so they can see how to place the connector. What we also always do, for example, we add this pin number one for the connectors, and yeah, I'm pretty sure you can come up with your own ideas. Just be very careful. Think also about the assembly, about the cables and all this stuff when you are creating footprint. So maybe you may want to add some useful information on the seal screen. Tip number 41, add more information on seal screen of some components, for example, connectors or slots. Why? Helps during assembly, can prevent placement issues during PCB design, for example, placing connectors too close to each other or placing the connectors or slots the other way around.